Hello, everyone, and welcome to the second semifinals match of the Roundtable Tournament. We're bringing you another Battle of the Titans this evening. We have George Frye versus Supun Liyanage. They're laying it all on the line this evening with their opportunity to battle against Chris Roper in the finals of the Roundtable Tournament. If you're unfamiliar, the Roundtable Tournament means that all of these individuals have been playing with the neutral candidates that have no bonuses and no penalties. Both of these players, very, very skilled, very good at strategically playing out the ballot rounds, playing out their bonuses, and this is sure to be a good one. I'm going to be sending out the code in just a moment here, and then we're going to get started. As you can see, this started with 42 players. They've had to go through quite a few rounds here to make it this far, but either Supun or George is going to have to take out the other in order to make it up to Chris in the finale. Hey, Tyler, how you doing, man? Okay, both of our players are in the building. It's time to get this underway. Siraj says, no offense to Chris Roper, but whoever wins this match will be the heavy favorite to win it all. You'd have to think so, wouldn't you? Buddy must be doing something right to get so far in this. I'd be curious to see where both of these players start. Here we go. Alright, looks like an Old South clash to start things off. Very interesting. Okay, so it looks like Supun has only gone into Georgia to start things off here. So it looks like George is going for a swath of Old South states, I assume, to ensure that he would have at least the minimum that he needs to get his bonus. Now, Supun must be spending that little bit in Georgia to see where George is starting his game out. Maybe kind of feel things out, see what the board's shaping up to look like, and I'm sure he's about to dive into somewhere now. I'll go ahead and make my spend. Here we go. As Tyler just predicted in the chat, Supun goes into the swing states. Absolutely. Widespread for the swing states, looks like. George going straight for that old south bonus. And he's gonna challenge in Virginia. Look at that, here we go. Got a nice little bonus already. Sir, I just says, wow, some demonic music here. This is a demonic battle. I'll go ahead and make my spend. Definitely looks like Supun is going to be getting his swing state bonus next turn. Let's see. Be interesting to see what George does after he gets his old south bonus. Virginia possibly going to be the first state locked in. Here we go. So we got a little fight over Arizona coming. Supun making the jump for his swing state bonus. Challenge North Carolina. Looks like George is jumping into some of his swing states. I do believe that'll be enough for Supun to get his bonus. Yes, it is. 100K for the swing states. That's going to be very helpful to put pressure on Virginia and North Carolina, possibly flip them. And I'll make my spend here. I don't know why I'm checking the bonuses. There's nothing there. Virginia Clash coming soon. Both of them have money to spend in Virginia. Okay, both operating around roughly the same amount of money, about a 70k split right now, 60k. Bernie did go into North Carolina, yes. Here we go. Pressure in Florida. Rubio into Georgia. Pressure in Louisiana. Lots of challenges here. Relatively low spend from both individuals. Check some of these comments. Sir Roger says, one of those rare matches where the streamer's candidate has more bonuses than the players. Yeah,
Figured, why not?
Tyler says, ooh yeah, North Carolina Steel will take away Old South. Or maybe he said, oh yeah, I'm not sure. I'll just put my own spin on it. That would be a good steal. Well, what do I know, Tyler?
I'm just some dipshit talking head.
Come on, someone, go for New York. Make me proud. Probably Supun should go for New York. In my infinite wisdom, I say Supun should go for New York. Yeah, actually, if Rubio grabs New York, he'd be getting pretty close to that AA bonus. Oh yeah, I could spend. That would be very helpful for everybody. If I don't say that once per stream. Tyler says, Supun will go Texas. I believe you. He's gonna go somewhere, I know that much. A lot of challenges right now, though. A lot of states in danger. Possible flip in Virginia, I love saying that. Someone's going to New York. It's gonna be me. I got plenty of money. Look at all that pressure. Both players taking their time thinking about this one. It's alright, I'll just flip through stuff. Here we go. Rubio goes into Alabama. Alright. Starting to spread out here. Clash in Massachusetts. Clash in Michigan. Looks like maybe both going for that high-tech bonus. Oh, both into New York, but Supun gets the edge. Clash in Utah. Oh yeah, both going for the town and gown grab or high-tech whatever. Yes! We got a Virginia steal! Throwdown in Virginia! What do you hear? What do you say? Let's go. Alright, so you have to imagine he's gonna cap that off now. Not gonna let that go. One more into New York, tie up Arizona, Iowa, New Hampshire, and you got yourself town and gown bonus. Absolutely. I'll make my spend in good old Nebraska, home of town and gown and agriculture. I don't know about you guys, but this game has messed with my head. Somebody mentions a state, and I'm like, they're manufacturing and agriculture and export, you know. Oh yeah, that's good, Tyler. That's real good. Thanks for telling us for the third time. Okay. North Carolina steel, maybe? Arizona? If you're just joining us now, this is the Roundtable Tournament semifinals. This is the tournament where every person is playing as a neutral candidate with no bonuses, with no penalties. The winner of this match will go on to face Chris Roper in the finals of the Roundtable Tournament at a time to be determined, probably very soon. Thank you again for being here. Feel free to leave your comments in the chat. If you have any guesses as to who may win this one, I'd be interested to see what you think there. Go ahead and answer the poll on the screen if you could, if you feel like it. Florida grab. Look at that. Oh, and Pennsylvania flips. Ouch. That's tough. Wowie. So there's gonna have to be an answer for that. Both not really having a lot of money yet. Not many, only one bonus on the table. African American, very close. Swing state, very close. Town and gown, going to be close. I'll go ahead and make my spend. Tyler says, Virginia flip was the difference for swing state. Absolutely. Absolutely. That was a killer. Once again, if you see the poll pop up on your screen, who do you think will win this match? Feel free to answer. I will show the results shortly. Yeah, that's a good zoom. All right. This song sounds like both of these individuals are about to go to a beach resort together and enjoy the white sands. Let's see, one of them may be going to Texas soon. Oh my God. So dramatic. This is like some ballot round shit right here. Holy hell. African American coming up soon, I think. AJ says an Ohio flip could make a difference. I will zoom into Illinois, Siraj. It's super important. Everybody's got to know what's happened with Illinois. The person singing is actually Brendan Borman. Okay, we have the results of our poll. Here we go. So the results of our poll, overwhelming for Supun. Overwhelming. So George Frye, something to prove here, it looks like. Here we go. And George steals Arizona. Moving into Colorado. Oh, and Supun swipes North Carolina. George grabs New Hampshire. Moving into New Mexico. And Supun grabs Ohio. Clash for Virginia. And Supun does collect the swing state bonus. I'll go ahead and make my spend now. Both individuals have a similar amount of money right now. Not enough money to double drop into any of the other two big states here. Let's see. So, if George picks up Mississippi, if he grabs back North Carolina and then Michigan, that would certainly be enough for the African American bonus. Now, Supun could grab manufacturing, obviously, of course, by getting Texas, or I think picking up 3 out of 4 of these, I think, would get it for him as well. Tyler says, Supun may grab back Florida right now. Rubio has at least 100K tied up in Old South. Let's take a look at that. So Tyler's saying, Rubio has at least 100K tied up in Old South, so that brings him back to 2. So the most he can do is go up to here. Means, yeah, that would be a very worthy steal right there. Okay. Huh. Don't mind that poll, because the answer is clear. He will try to steal back Florida. And Virginia is locked. Ooh, look at that. Big reversal for Bernie here. Played by Supun. Tough match so far for these individuals. Hard fought. And that pulls George further and further away from that African American bonus. Surely he was expecting on having that money by now. Go ahead and make my spend. Let's see. What are we close to here? Very surprised that Supun hasn't tried to just get that town and gown bonus going. But maybe I'm just surprised because I'm an idiot. That's possible. If you're George, this is unfortunate. Although, he could have been expecting it too. Manufacturing, still fairly close here. I think it's agriculture, about halfway there for Supun. I'm sure we're going to see someone move into Cali or Texas here soon. Okay, I'm about to ask a hard-hitting question in the chat on the video. My question is, which will now be posed in the chat window, who will win Montana? Who will win the important and amazing state of Montana by the end of this matchup? Here we go. Supun grabs and locks in Arizona. He's moving into the District of Columbia. Interesting, and George does not spend that round. Not sure, maybe he's having a connection issue. Surely, I'm sure George, of course, knows about the end turn button, so not sure what happened there. We're going end turn. Well, George has a money advantage now. He could steal back Florida, potentially. Siraj says, New York steal attempt, I think, saving for it. Yeah? That's possible. That would be a helpful maneuver for him. Let's see. If George grabs New York, I wonder if that would be enough for the African-American bonus. I think it might be. Tyler says, it's his if he wants it. Supun doesn't have enough to defend. All right. Well, perhaps he may take it then. Let's check some things out here. Maybe he could steal North Carolina back as well. I feel like we might see the end of the Florida shenanigans. Supun, maybe into Texas soon. Yep, Tyler, yep, just saw that now, I agree, yeah. I also think he's gonna pivot to Texas. That would be beneficial for him bonus-wise. He'd pick up manufacturing, he'd be very close, if not already having enough for agriculture. It would bring him much closer to export. Yeah, that would be and he'd only be a couple of states away from oil as well, so Texas would be a very opportune state for Supun at this juncture. I think we can expect George to be picking up a lot more electoral soon.
Siraj says, why is the poll question about Montana and not Arkansas? Does the poll guy not know what he's doing? Yeah, but Siraj, I already asked who was going to win the match. I'm not going to ask the same question twice. Diversification, gentlemen. We got to mix things up a bit. Here we go. Into DC. Patch job in Florida. It's like Oh, yes! And he steals New York. And Supun does move into Texas. Two big moves here. And it didn't make him lose any bonuses, but it did help Rubio gain the African American bonus. Look at the money. 15K difference. Supun, if he has the money, maybe a Texas double here. Rubio, maybe into California at this point. Very close to high tech. Supun could be positioning himself for oil. Just jumps into a couple more here. Town and gown also very close. The results are in. All think George Frye will get Montana. Oh yeah, I could spend. Good stuff. Okay. Keep your eyes on North Carolina. Cali, maybe. I'm going to reopen the poll from earlier. Who do you think will win this match? George Frye and Supun. Earlier, Supun had all the votes. Feel free to re-vote here. Oh! Big steal by George Frye, North Carolina. And Supon's about to get that big Texas money. Yeehaw! Very close. Rubio, two big groups here. Bernie, manufacturing. I'll make my spend. If you're just joining us now, this is the semifinals of the Roundtable Tournament. Two amazing competitors, George Frye and Supun Liyanage, competing against each other to go on to the finals of the Roundtable, competing against a rising star, I would say, Chris Roper. Should be an interesting matchup either way. Now, I personally have not seen much of Chris in the player tournaments. However, I have played Chris several times in the public lobby. I think he often plays as Hillary, if I can remember correctly. If that's not true, Chris, sorry. But Chris is a great player. Looking forward to seeing how that match turns out. Tyler says, North Carolina flip prevented the agriculture bonus. That was a great move by Frye. Definitely. Oh yeah, look at that. That's tough. Look at that. Here we go. Supun moving into Alabama. George moving into Cali. He steals Delaware and DC. North Carolina locked in. New Hampshire steal locked by George Frye. Look at that. 238 to 215. Let's see how many states are locked in. 20, 35, 48, 52. About halfway there. Both of these competitors living on a prayer. Just about halfway there. Latino bonus, super close. Oil and gas, super close. Agriculture, super close. Export, super close. George, slight money advantage here. He's got four bonuses to Bernie's two bonuses. Nearly has the agriculture bonus here. Doesn't look like Bernie has enough juice to take over New York here. May see him have to do a little bit of defending in Florida, wrap that up. Although I feel as though you can probably expect George to spend 400k in California this turn, so if you're Supun, now's the turn to make a big move, possibly. I'll make my spend. You guys see me where I keep zooming in on the screen like that? It's my scroll wheel whenever I'm switching over to the chat window to make sure I'm seeing all the comments. Just about a minute 30 left here in turn 13 of this semifinal matchup. Siraj says, zoom into Illinois one more time. Absolutely, Siraj. Just for you, buddy. Look at that shape. Oh, yeah. Gonna go all around those curves. Here's one for the old timers. Who remembers when they added the shade to each state? Pepperidge Farm remembers. I remember it made the game look weird for a couple of days, and I was like, it's nice, but it's throwing me off a little bit. Yes, it used to just be plain white around here. That's what Grandpa has to tell you. Here we go. Oh! Oh, George tries to steal Florida, and Supun makes him pay. But George does take Iowa, though. George went for a risk move there, and it didn't quite pay off. He's got some other steals, but that's a tough loss. Supun jumping into the chat. F yeah, I guess. My sponsors don't like it when I swear, or, you know, I'd be wilding out right now. Look at that. If you're Supun, you're riding high right now. That's 400k that could have gone somewhere else. Tyler Brola says, that must have been satisfying. Yeah, I bet. It's always super satisfying when you block someone like that. And when you're the person that gets blocked, you want to take your fucking computer and smash it into the wall. Look how close we are to oil and gas bonus. That almost looks like a missed opportunity. Honestly. Was he blocked somewhere, maybe? Not sure. Gotta love the good old Florida cock block. Make my spend. Sorry if I've been shouting, by the way. I think I've maybe have had this music too loud in my ears. We're all good now. We've calmed down. Let's see. Money. Super even. Super even money. Oh yeah, I definitely think I had that music too loud. Super even money. Oil. Very close. Export. Just as close. Now, if Bernie were to flip Louisiana, I believe that would be enough for Bernie to collect export and oil and gas bonus in one. That would be pretty nice. Definitely see some flips coming up soon. How many electorals we got? 20, 35, 48, 52. Still 52. Jesus Christ. Well, I guess I've been spoiled by these games that always end at turn 13 because of Tyler Barola. Mr. Fucking Fast Ballot over there. Nothing wrong with that, by the way. Who doesn't love a good fast ballot? Seconds remaining on the clock. Turn 14. Showdown in New Mexico? I think so. Might be a big waste of money, but Louisiana could be a good grab. Just for those two bonuses. Although he has to maintain everything else, too. The Camacho special. Absolutely. Here we go. Looks like maybe both of them going for a ballot, or maybe both going for oil and gas. So we certainly don't have enough locked up yet. Hey, Louisiana, defense, Michigan, defense. Montana, Supon's in. New Mexico, steal and a lock for Supon. Okay. Both these gentlemen keeping things very, very close throughout this whole match. Definitely so far fulfilling the premonition that this is going to be a ballot round nail biter. Supon, big money advantage right now. He's got about 400k on his opponent, George Frye. Export bonus, maybe in play next turn. Very possible. I'll go ahead and make my spend now so I don't forget. Keep thine eyes on Michigan. Michigan, maybe something's gonna go on there. Who knows? Who knows? Great game to both of these competitors so far. Really close match already. Well fought so far. Already fixing up to be a real tight matchup by the ballot round. Congratulations to both of these folks already for getting this far and just for putting on this match. Last states could be in play this turn. Georgia, Illinois, possibly. These oil states, I think, are definitely in play right now. Shout out to 270 for these colors not being exactly the same. Very helpful to call the game when the colors aren't the same. Yeah, and there's nothing like calling a match where it's like orange and slightly less orange, and it's like, oh, shit. So hard to tell who has what. Let's see. So it seems like George could steal the Latino bonus from Supon if he snags Illinois or Nevada even. I mean, obviously if he grabs Florida, forget it there, but... to be honest, I'm not even really sure who has the advantage right now. I'm really not sure. It seems fairly split up. How many boats? We'll have to see after. Okay. Flash in Arkansas. Bernie's in Georgia. Oh, he was already in Georgia, wasn't he? Whatever. Flash in Idaho. Louisiana's locked for George Frye, Marco Rubio. Bernie putting pressure everywhere.
Oh, and George steals Ohio. Just pulling Supun under 270 electorals. And now he's back over 270. Look at that. George is going to collect the export bonus. I'll make my spend. About a 200k difference between these two individuals. All the state groups now locked up. George has 5 to Supon's also 5, so we got an even split here. Even split of the state groups. Electorals, we got 25, 31, 39, 49, 54, 64, 67, 87, 91. Very close to up to the ballot churn here. 9 more electorals to lock in, I believe, if my math is correct. So we're nearly there. Maybe two turns to go, perhaps. Siraj says, Arkansas, the last state to be spent in. Of course the game is even.
Yeah. Can't make any arguments there. Mistakes have been made because no one's in Arkansas. Hey, Jamie, welcome. We're in the middle of a really close match between George and Supun right now. Should be a ballot in just a couple of turns, so it's good time to tune in here, definitely.
Here we go. Bernie, moving up in Alaska. Both gentlemen in Arkansas. Florida, nearly locked. Oh, there it is. George steals Illinois. That could come back to haunt Supun. And George steals Nevada as well.
Oh, look at that. Supun steals Ohio back.
270 to 268. Wow, look at that. Do we have enough for a ballot? Oh no, look at that. Tough loss there. Great steal by George Frye.
Oh, and we do have a ballot.
We will have a ballot. 270 to 268.
As predicted by our commissioner, Daniel Smith, we will have a ballot round throwdown.
Woo! This is gonna be a tough one. Look at this. Look at the heartland of America. Holy shit. Look at it. This is gonna be a tough one. This is gonna be an exciting ballot round. George Frye. Supun Liyanage. This is gonna be sick. So many different options here for both of these guys. Money, fairly similar. Big turn.
Whoever pulls this off successfully will go on to the final matchup of the Roundtable Tournament against rising star Chris Roper. It all comes down to this. How these two gentlemen spend their last cash of money here will determine the victor.
Either competitor, just inches away from victory.
Jamie says, no way a Democrat would win these traditional Republican states in real life.
Well, welcome to 270.
Santa Claus ain't winning shit either.
Yeah, it is funny how certain states like Utah are practically a Democratic stronghold in 270, and yet, yes, in real life, that would basically never happen. It is pretty funny.
Just about a minute left. 1 minute until we find out who's going on to the final matchup of the Roundtable Tournament.
Both individuals fighting tooth and nail to make it to this point. Now they just need to figure out how to thread the needle.
Seconds remaining. We're just about to find out who will be the winner of this semi-final matchup. Here we go. Supun steals Alabama. George steals Arkansas. George steals Connecticut. Supun steals the District of Columbia. Supun steals Delaware. Supun jumping ahead in Idaho. Illinois locked in by George Frye. Clash for Kansas. I believe that one stays with Supun. Supun with a big steal of Mississippi. Starting to pull away here. Oh, not so fast. Missouri, stolen by George Frye. North Dakota, pulling away for Supun. Clash in Nebraska. Nevada, big steal by Supun. Defense in New York. Oregon flips to George Frye. Rhode Island, clash. Tight race. South Dakota stays with Bernie. Tennessee, clash. Vermont flips to George Frye. Wisconsin. Oh! And Supun Liyanage takes it. 271 to 267. Razor thin margin here, folks. Congratulations, Supun, you are going on to the finals of the Roundtable Tournament, where you will compete against Chris Roper in the finale. Hard-fought match for George. George, great game. Either one of you could have won that. Truly, an amazing match. Very exciting ballot round. Wow, and look at that, he lost the popular vote even. He loses the popular vote by nearly 5 million. That is pretty significant. What a match. What a match in this round table. Huge victory for Supun. And he will have his opportunity to win the first round table tournament. Wow. Amazing. hard-fought match to both of these competitors. Congratulations, Supun. Be sure to watch Supun compete in the upcoming final match of the Roundtable Tournament against Chris Roper. And check out George Frye and Supun in the upcoming Season 2 of the Rio Hondo League, starting July 31st. Amazing match. Thank you again, Daniel Smith, for commissioning this awesome tournament. Thank you all for joining us here tonight. This is Tyler DeMori, King of the North, signing out. Have a beautiful evening.